Hello viewers, if you are new to the channel, please hit the like and subscribe button and share it with your friends. Also, click on the bell icon so that you get the latest information about the videos that are uploaded. Hello students, welcome back to the new video. In this video, we will continue the ongoing chapter number 9, Soil. In today's session, we will discuss about the formation of soil. Students, in the previous session, we have already learned that soil is found on the uppermost layer of the earth and the plants grow on it. So, where is soil found? Soil found on the uppermost layer in which the plants grow. And also, we have learned that soil is composed of a mixture of organic matter, clay and rock particle. So, what is the composition of soil? Soil contains organic matter, clay and rock particles. Now, how is actually soil formed? Soil is formed from the rock particles by a process called weathering. So, the soil formation from the rock is called weathering. So, now today we will discuss about weathering process in detail. First of all, let us see the definition of weathering. Weathering is the process in which rocks are broken down into smaller pieces by the action of wind, water and temperature. So, these factors like wind, water and temperature are known as the agents of weathering. So, what is weathering? Weathering is the process in which rocks are broken down into smaller pieces. And what are the causes of this? This breaking down of rocks is caused by the factors like wind, water and temperature. Therefore, these three factors are known as agents of weathering. Now, as the rocks breaks down, they mix with the organic materials which originate from living organisms. What does it mean? As soon as the rocks are broken down into pieces, they mix with the organic materials. And what is the source of organic material? Living organism. So now the soil, that is pieces of rocks, are mixed with the organic matter. Further, the process of weathering is slow and continuous. What does it mean? Weathering takes lots of time and it is not a process that it gets over within a short period of time. It goes on continuously. So, we can say that weathering is a slow and continuous process. And because of that, it takes hundreds of years to produce few centimeters of soil. It shows that how slow the process of weathering is. Now, weathering is of three types. It means that depending on the cause of weathering, it can be divided into three types. Which are they? Physical weathering, chemical weathering and biological weathering. So, weathering can be divided into three types. Physical, chemical and biological weathering. Further, physical weathering is also termed as mechanical weathering. So, what is another name of physical weathering? It is mechanical weathering. In mechanical weathering, rocks are broken down into pieces by the action of the physical forces like wind, frost, temperature changes, etc. As the name indicates, the mechanical weathering takes place by the action of physical forces like wind, frost, temperature changes, etc. Now, we will discuss about chemical weathering. In chemical weathering, the mineral composition of the rocks get changed due to the action of chemical agents like water, oxygen, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, etc. So which are the chemical agents that cause weathering? Even water is an agent. Oxygen, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, etc. They are present in the nature. So when these chemical agents react with the minerals in the rock, what changes takes place? They react with the minerals in the rock to form new minerals and soluble salts. So when the chemical agents react with the minerals in the rock, they form new minerals and soluble salts. You know that soil contains some soluble salts which are necessary for the plants to grow. So where do that new and soluble salts come from? From the rocks from which the soil is formed. See, the soil formed by the chemical weathering is different in its chemical composition from the original rock. What is the reason? Because of the chemical reaction, the new original minerals get changed to form new minerals. Now we will discuss about biological weathering. In biological weathering, living organisms such as plants and microorganisms contribute to the weathering process. That means living organisms are the cause of weathering. See, the roots of trees grow into the cracks in rocks. They split the rocks apart and break them into pieces. What does it happen? Here, when the roots of the trees and other plants reach the cracks in the rocks, they make the rocks into pieces, or they split apart and break them into pieces, and thus soil is formed. And the other living organisms like bacteria and lichens that live on the rocks produce certain acids that act on the rock very slowly and cause weathering. You know that bacteria is a microorganism. It can be seen anywhere. And lichen is an association of alga and fungus. When these microorganisms and lichens live on the rocks, they produce certain acids. And rocks are made up of minerals. So these acids react with the minerals in the rock and cause weathering. That means here the soil is formed by the action of living organisms, so we call it as biological weathering. Now let us see how the formation of soil actually takes place. Then due to the action of earthquakes push out the rocks, and the rolling large rocks get broken down into smaller ones. That means even the earthquake play a role in the formation of soil. Due to the earthquake, the bigger rocks are pushed out, and when they roll down, it gets broken down into smaller pieces. Next, the action of water. You know that rainwater enters in the narrow cracks of rocks. In winter, as this water freezes, it expands. So this expansion breaks the rocks into smaller pieces due to the pressure. So what happens due to the action of water? There are small cracks or narrow cracks in the rocks. When the rainwater enters into these cracks, and in winter season when the temperature goes below 0°C, the water freezes to form ice. And you know that ice expands, or water expands on freezing. So due to the expansion of the water, what happens? It exerts pressure on all sides of the rocks. So due to this pressure, the rocks get broken down into smaller pieces. In this way, water also plays a very important role in the formation of soil. Now let us see what is the role of temperature on the formation of soil, that is heating and cooling of the rocks. Alternate heating and cooling due to the heat of the sun and rain cause the rocks to crack. That means when the rocks get heated up, it expands, and when the temperature goes down, it gets contracted. So this rocks expand on heating and contract on cooling. This expansion and contraction result in the formation of cracks within the rocks, and finally they break into smaller pieces. So this expansion and contraction cause the rocks to crack, and finally that is broken down into pieces. Therefore, temperature also play an important role in the formation of soil. Next, the roots of trees grow in size and help to break the rocks into smaller pieces. So all these factors helps the rock to break down into smaller pieces and form the soil. Now, how does the soil become fertile? See, the remains of dead plants and animals present in the soil are decomposed by the microorganisms and form humus. Because you know that the remains of dead plants and animals are known as humus. So this humus makes the soil fertile. Along with that, the minerals and salts from the weathered rocks that also get dissolved in the rainwater and slowly added to the soil. This makes the soil very fertile. That means the humus and the minerals and salts from the weathered rocks make the soil very fertile and supplies the plants with the nutrients so that they can grow well. So these are the different ways by which the soil is formed. So students, I hope you have understood the topics very well. But still, if you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section. I will surely try to solve it as soon as possible. Here are some review questions. Please solve it in your notebook. Thank you.